Hello, my name is Tine. In this video I'll make another 45 degree chamfer tool for minilathe. I already made one of them years ago and turned out as very useful tool, but I'll make it very simple so it wasn't that precise. This time I'll complicate a bit more but still make it on easiest possible way. I still got some of that square inserts, which is great for cutting all material from inox to aluminium. This time I also prepared some sketches for easier work. All I need is some steel rods, I use the one with more carbon in it, an insert and mounting screw, in my case is M2.2. Okay, first of all prepare the base piece. It turned out that 7x8mm is right dimension, so I stick to it. I got here 8x10mm rod, which is just perfect to clean all around, but firstly cut it to length about 80mm. So far I got nice piece of stick, built the right dimension. Before continue I just sand the sharp edges, so the vise wouldn't deform it if there stays some chip from milling. Then clean the vise and mount my homemade turntable. It got 360 marks around, but it's more for orientation. To set 45 degree more precisely, I use edge finder in combination with DRO. But I set even more accurate with angle measure tool and micrometer gauge. When I got the vise mounted at 45 degree, firstly make the 2mm hole into center of holder, about 8.5mm from end, and drill 3.5mm deep. I start with tiny centering drill, so I get a position, and then use 2mm end mill to get flat bottom of hole, but you can use drill bit without problem. Then I move mill to that position. Because I got clamped holder by 45 degree, I need to move x-axis for 1mm and y-axis for 1mm. So I'm again in center of holder, but about 1.41mm from center of hole. You know, Pythagorean that. When I'm on the position, set digital readout x and y-axis to 0, and that's the point I shouldn't mill over. That's the area I need to cut away. It's 3mm deep, like the insert. And all I need to care is that I don't mill over the 0 point. And not to broke my 2mm mill, of course. And that's the result. Now I need to cut the chamfer for the insert, which is tilted for 8 degree. I still need to get holder clamped by 45 degree and also tilted them for 8 degree. I do that on simplest possible way. I just cut a piece of wood by 8 degrees and put them under the turntable, so entire table is tilted for 8 degrees. Now just cut chamfers so the mill cut entire area from top to bottom. Then turn the table for 90 degrees and repeat it on other side. And that's what I got. It's so small that the chamfer isn't visible, but we can see angle cut it from the side, and insert fits to its place surprisingly well. Now I need to cut bottom chamfer to get negative angle under the insert. I just mark the position of insert so I know how far to cut. Leave the turntable as it is, turn it for 45 degrees and tilt it for 8 degrees. Just mill on other side of ice to get negative angle. When it's done, turn table for 90 degrees and cut negative chamfer on other side. Now we get something like this, and guess what? It's exactly what I got here. Holder got its final shape, and insert fits perfectly to its place. I'm really satisfied with the result. Now all I need to do is treat for the screw. I simply mark the position of it and find the center on mill. Firstly I mark with step drill, but not into center of insert. Drill for a hundredth or two closer to chamfer, so the screw push the insert towards the holder and hold it on position more solid. Then drill with 1mm drill all the way through. For M2.2 you need to drill 1.75mm hole, but I only got 1.7 drill, which should be okay. Cut a bit of chamfer on both sides. Then I insert M2.2 thread cutter into mill chuck and turn few times, just to position them on right angle. Then continue to cut manually, because with that tiny thread cutters we always walk on the edge. Especially into steel we broke it faster than the cookie crumble. For the end I just cut one more pass on top of holder, to clean traces I leave while finding zero point with the mill. Then sand all the sharp edges with diamond file and sandpaper. Now I just screw on the insert and my new tool is ready to use. I make this tool because a friend asked me if I can make one for himself, so before last step I make it one more. And now final step, make tool look better. Basically small parts like that I heat up and drop into flaxseed oil to get black surface and protection against rust, but this time I'll use blackening solution. In that process it's very important to degrease surface really well. I wipe it with alcohol, but surface still wasn't evenly blackened. After 10 minutes I take it out of solution and wipe them. But that solution only makes surface black, so for rust protection we still need to seal it with oil. I just wipe it with flaxseed oil in combination with heat, so the grease evaporate and tools stay clean. After it cooled down, the result is much better, but black still isn't evenly. I'm sure I got much better result with hot process of blackening. Just for fun, I tried to engrave holder type on it, so it really looked like I buy them. Result would be much better if I own fiber laser, but it's okay for me. Let's mount the tool into holder now and make a first try. Firstly, I make a simple cone to check if it cut by 45 degree. It's quite close, but didn't check if the tool post mounted 100% perpendicular. Anyway, more than good enough for amateur like me. As I said, the tool is great to cut in almost any side, facing in one or other side, turning in one or other side, and chamfering. I also use the tool in all materials, from aluminium, brass, to steel and inox. It's iscar inserts for drills with replacing inserts, but turn out really good also on a lathe. I used them many times to shorten the screws. I just add another screw so the jaws clamp it on two points, cut it on length I need, and then face and chamfer them with a single tool, and get nice treat every time. Let's try them now on a few different materials. That's about it for today. Quick afternoon project, bring me new tool, which turned out quite well. I think that's really good way to spend some time. I know I make a lot of mistakes in machining, but it's not my job and I have no mechanical education. I just do that because I like it. Hope you see something new anyway. Thanks for watching, like, share and subscribe if you like, and see you next time.